What's up, y'all? I'm Strainer Sanders, and you're tuned to the infamous Living Rim Network. I got a few tips that I want you to know on how you could be blocking the law of attraction. Why the law of attraction is not working for you. Most people understand, the law of attraction is so easy. It could just work for me. All I got to do is ask, believe, and receive. Oh, man, it is so easy. I don't have to do nothing. I can just sit back and use my mind and just manifest all pleasantly, heavenly, and gratefully. But that's not really the case, folks. Some things that you want to manifest will not come to you. Why? Because if you was following me on Facebook, you will understand that I said, because you have to go get it. Some things you can't manifest to you, folks. Some things you have to go get. You understand what I'm saying? So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and get right down into it. Because I'm going to tell you some of the things that could be blocking you from law of attracting the things that you want into your life. So divine powers are always working for us because we're trying to do right. Now, the first things first, I'm going to go ahead and go clear this up right now. One of the first and most easiest things that could be blocking you from achieving or receiving a thing that you want to manifest, folks, is your very own friends that are around you. Yeah, I know. Curly, Larry, and Mo. Your regular, everyday friends. Some friends around you do not want the same things that you want, folks. I tell my people on Rim Team that I talk to that are not subscribers that I signed up for Rims. I tell them this all the time. I say, listen. If you want to go and become some certain type of person, or I know it's yourself that you want to become or whatever, but if you want to be great and you want to be lovely and marvelous and all these other things that are concluded as wonderful, folks, you have to make sure that you surround yourself with those same type of people. Excited, wonderful, bubbly, marvelous, great people. And sometimes we want to law of attract things into our life, and sometimes we don't have those things in our life. We don't have those people in our life that are feeling upbeat and up-tempo and just ready to go and just ready to take on life. You know what I'm saying? So, friends. First things first, friends. Folks, you got to have the right type of friends in your life. I personally have the right type of friends in my life. I ain't even going to go through all the different type of friends I have in my life. But I have all different kinds of friends in my life that influence me to have the energy and the vibration to make this video that I'm making right now. The second thing that I want you to understand in order to law of attract things into your life and keep them blocking you is you got to change your environment, folks. Some of you are staying in environments that don't allow you to attract the thing that you want to attract. You got to make sure that you're in a proper environment. You know, that if you're in this environment, I know I'm going to attract this because all these people around here want the same thing I want. You know what I'm saying? So you got to make sure that you get into environments where it attracts that vibration of where you want to go. You know, once upon a time when I wanted to do music, I moved to Atlanta. And when I moved to Atlanta, I immediately got into the music industry. And I started to attract the things that I wanted to attract. Once upon a time, I wanted to do banking. And I wanted to learn more about finances. So I moved to Charlotte, North Carolina. Charlotte, North Carolina is the place of the banking capital of the United States of America. So I began to attract all different type of friends that work at Bank of America, that work at Wachovia, that work at BB&T, you know, that work at Wells Fargo. I began to attract all different type of friends from Charlotte, in Charlotte, that work in the financial arena. So that's what I'm saying. The reason why you probably cannot attract the certain thing that you want to attract is probably because you're not in the right city, you're not in the right town, you're not in the right environment, folks. So that's another thing that could be blocking you from law of attracting. The next thing is that a lot of people don't like to take risk, and that's fine. But if you're cool with being comfortable, then being comfortable is for you. But I know for a person like me and for my friends that I hang around, we don't like to be comfortable. We like to take risks. We like to make sacrifices. We like to do things, you know, concerning the unknown. We like to go out and uncharted the uncharted territory of life and just see where we will land. And most of the time, we land on our feet. Most of the time, we do good. And so I'm saying the same thing to you. If you want to law of attract the thing that you want the law of attracting to your life, you have to make sure that you're constantly taking risk. And so this goes into the next thing. You cannot, I say this once again, you cannot be living in limiting thought beliefs. limiting thought patterns, limited thought patterns that are trying to hold you back. Folks, some of the thought beliefs and the thought patterns that most people live in are traditional thought patterns and thought beliefs. Something that their grandmother and their grandmother thought, and the way they did things is the way they taught you to do things, and the way you do things is the way they did things. You got to get out of that thinking. If you want a law of attract multi-millions of dollars, if you want a law of attract new people into your life, new husband, whatever you want to attract into your life, you got to get out of the habit of living in traditional thought beliefs, folks. Got to break out of that shell and, you know, have your sight set on something totally different from what you're normally focused on. You know, that's very important. That is entirely important. That's one thing that I had to realize. Once upon a time, I used to be the same type of person. I used to have limits and beliefs. You know, once upon a time, I didn't even want to get in front of a camera because I thought that everybody would look at me as somebody weird because I'm talking about weird things. I literally thought this. Like, I literally thought that, you know, the things that I like to think about are weird things. And I really thought that nobody on my Facebook, nobody on my Twitter, and my MySpace at the time would like really be receptive to the things that I'm talking about. And I like to talk about space. I like to talk about science. I like to talk about metaphysics. I like to talk about ontology. I like to talk about psychology. I like to talk about all those different types of things. And once upon a time, don't you know, I used to think that all those things were weird. Like, I really did. And so I was so afraid to talk about things like that. You know, and another thing that could be blocking you from the law of attraction, folks, I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to be real with you, straight up genuine. Make sure you subscribe over here. Don't forget, folks, your job. Your job could be holding you back from attracting the thing that you want to attract into your life. Some of y'all, if you were just like me, chose to take on jobs that you just took on just to pay your rent or just to pay your bills. That's cool. But what are you really here for? What are you in this city for? What did you come to this city for? Did you come to this city to be an actor or an actress? You know what I'm saying? Like, did you come to this city to be a music producer? Did you come to this city to be an author? Did you come to this city to be a painter? What are you doing this for? Who are you wanting to be? So if you're doing a job that you really don't love to do, but you're doing it just to pay some bills, you can't expect to, like, get the thrills. You can't expect to, like, law of attract the thing that you want to attract into. Like, the law of attraction is not going to work. For instance, if you want to be an author, right? Okay, you want to attract new clients in your life or whatever to read your book. I ain't going to say new clients, but new readers into your life that want to read your book or whatever, right? Okay, so if you are working at a job, working on tires, and you meet people that come in there to get their car fixed, and you be like, hey, I'm an author. I can guarantee you, if you give them your author card, you give them your business card or whatever the case may be, if you tell them about your blog, I guarantee you they ain't going to look at it. Because they're going to be like, this person was working on my tires in my car. They talking about they an author. They ain't no author. They ain't no author. They had tire and skid marks all over them. I'm not going to read they book talking about romanticism and love. I'm just not going to do it. So it goes back to what I was saying. Like, for instance, if you want to be a famous author, folks, you have to make sure that you put yourself in an environment to where people will actually, you know, listen to, you know, what you have to say as, you know, I'm an author, you know, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this thing or whatever. And they're going to listen to your business card. You know, they're going to look at the information that you give them or whatever the case may be. You understand what I'm saying? It's common sense. Once upon a time, I used to want to be a real big music artist. So what I did was I moved to Atlanta, Georgia. And then I got in school. Even though I didn't graduate, I got into the field of doing music or whatever. And then I started in the field immediately. And I started becoming like an IT digital technology personnel for record label and whatnot. And I started to automatically run into the artists and stuff that I look up to. And then, boom, I had my way into the music business. Even though that's what I didn't land in, I ended up being a vlogger. But I'm just going to show you the necessary steps that I took to actually become like a music artist. I moved to the city where the vibration of music was. Then when I moved to that city, because that was something that I really loved to do. Same thing. If you want to be like a movie actress, you move to Los Angeles. And you start doing great things out there in Los Angeles. You understand what I'm saying? And then next thing you know, you'll start to run into more people that are doing the same thing you do. And they start telling you information and such and such and blah, blah, blah. Next thing you know, you'll be on Hollywood. You know what I mean? You'll be in Hollywood just like that. Just like that. And people be like, how did she do it? How did she do it? Easy. She went to Hollywood. She wanted to be a part of Hollywood. She went to Hollywood. It's as simple as that. Okay? So, man, and then one thing I got to tell you amongst all this, folks, is that if you want to do anything, if you want to law of attract anything, folks, and if you want to do it wholeheartedly, make sure that you burn all the ships that you came on. If you got a plan B, folks, you already lost. If you start second guessing whether or not you're going to make it, if you relocate to this location versus where you're at right now, folks, you're already lost. Make sure that you burn all bridges. Make sure you burn all ships. Make sure that you only have a plan A. And plan A is the plan that you plan to do when you get to where you're going to go or become who you're going to become. Because everything else will fail after that. Plan B, C, D, all that's going to fail. So I'm just telling you this right now, folks. Trust and believe. I done already been there and I done already done that. I done already traveled to major cities and tried to pursue career paths or whatever the case may be. I done done that. Okay, and I'm telling you straight up, you gotta burn the ships that you came in. Otherwise, you will fail. And I'm telling you this as a Rim Team member. And if you're not signed to Rim Team, folks, make sure you sign up versus being a subscriber over here in the bottom right-hand corner. If you wanna watch more of my interesting videos, just go up here, click this link right here. I got another pretty interesting video that you might like. Speak up, let your voice be heard. Leave a comment below. Let me know if this video resonated with you, if you liked it, what did you think about it? You know, are you doing some things to unblock the law of attraction? Or do you notice some things that have blocked you from the law of attraction that I mentioned in this video? Or if it's some new things, let us know. Speak up, let your voice be heard so everybody else can know. In the meantime, folks, I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace and blessings, folks. Peace.